The Legend of Turtle Island, an Ojibwe Anishinaabe creation story, retold as a play by Miss Josephine Sherman, narrator Mrs. Daniel. Long, long ago, the great spirit called Kichi Manitou first placed people on the earth. After a while, these original people began to argue with one another. Kichi Manitou did not like that. Kichi Manitou said,
"You must be peaceful and respect all living things. Try to be at peace with each other."
But the people did not listen and kept on with their ways. Kichi Manitou decided to teach them a lesson. Kichi Manitou said,
"Let there be a great flood upon the earth."
And indeed there was a great flood, which covered every part of the earth. The earth was now covered in water. Only Nanabuzo survived the flood. He was a kind and sensible person, not like the others. He was able to take a few animals and birds along, who managed to swim and fly. Nanabuzo floated on a huge log, searching for land.
"There must be some land,"
said Nanabuzo.
"I will keep searching."
But none was found on the earth. The earth was covered by a great flood. And from time to time, Nanabuzo allowed the remaining animals and birds to take turns resting on the log. Finally, Nanabuzo spoke.
"I am going to do something. I will swim to the bottom of this water and grab a handful of earth. With this small bit of earth, I think we can create a new land for us to live. We will ask the four winds and Kichi Manitou to help us."
So Nanabuzo dived into the water. He was gone for a long time. Finally, he came back to the top of the water. Nanabuzo was short of breath, but said to the animals,
"The water is too deep. I cannot swim to the bottom."
All the animals and birds were silent. Finally, the loon spoke up.
"I can dive under the water for a long way. That is how I catch my food. My body is shaped for diving and my web feet are very strong. I will try to make it to the bottom and return with some earth in my beak."
The loon disappeared and was gone for a very long time. The other animals and birds thought,
"Loon must have drowned."
Then they saw Loon float up to the surface, feeling very weak. Loon gasped,
"I couldn't make it. There must be no bottom to this water, but there must be earth at the bottom. Let's not give up."
Then Spirit Bird came forward. Spirit Bird said,
"I will try next. Everyone knows I could dive great distances in the water."
So the bird dove down deep into the water. Again, a long time passed. The others thought,
"Spirit Bird must have drowned,"
they said. At last, Spirit Bird floated to the surface. Spirit Bird was very tired, but said,
"I could not reach the bottom, and I was not able to fetch any earth."
Then after a while, Ming said,
I will try. My body is sleek and I could dive great distances.
Mink dove into the water and was not seen for a long time. The animals again all thought,
"Surely Mink has drowned."
They said, "The mink came to the surface."
I also could not reach the bottom.
Mink said with a weak voice, and more time passed. Turtle said,
"I will try. I'm a good swimmer and my flippers take me down a long way."
So Turtle dove into the water and was gone for a long time. All the animals and birds thought,
"Surely Turtle has drowned."
Then Turtle came to the surface.
"It is too far and I cannot reach the bottom,"
said Turtle sadly. All had failed. It seemed that there was no way to get the mud from the bottom. Then a soft, quiet voice said,
"I can do it."
At first, no one could see who it was that had said that. Then Little Muskrat stepped forward.
"I will try,"
repeated Muskrat. Some of the other bigger animals and birds laughed at Muskrat. And Nana Boozer said,
"If Muskrat wants to try, he should be allowed to."
A very long time passed. Muskrat was gone longer than any of the others who tried to reach the bottom. After a while, Nana Boozer and all the animals and birds thought, far below the water's surface, Muskrat had indeed reached the bottom. Very weak from lack of air, he grabbed some earth in his paw, and with all the energy he had left, he began to swim for the surface. Nana Boozer pulled Muskrat up onto the log.
"Dear friends, Muskrat went too long without air. He has drowned,"
said Nana Boozer. A song of sadness was heard across the water, and Muskrat's spirit passed on to the spirit world. Nana Boozer carefully opened his paws and said,
"There is a small ball of earth in his paw."
The animals and the birds all jumped with joy. Muskrat had done it, they said. He had brought some earth so that life could begin again. Nana Boozer took the piece of earth from Muskrat's paw. Just then, Turtle swam by.
"Use my back to bear the weight of this piece of earth. With the help of Kichi Manitou, we can make a new earth."
Nana Boozer put the piece of earth on Turtle's back. Kichi Manitou looked down from the sky. Suddenly, the wind blew from each of the four directions. The west wind blew, the east wind blew, the north wind blew, the south wind blew. The tiny piece of earth on the turtle's back began to grow. It grew, and it grew, and it grew, until it formed an island in the water. The island grew larger and larger, but still the turtle carried the weight of the earth on its back. Nana Boozer and all the animals and birds all sang and danced in a big circle on the growing island. After a while, the four winds stopped blowing and the water became still. A huge island sat in the middle of the water. Today, that island is called North America.